I felt so overwhelmed with grief and with shame. I could not believe that I had done that. That I had sacrificed one of the most precious things in the world for a piece of paper.
To her friends, Rhonda Courtney was upbeat and fun-loving. But things were not as they appeared.
Growing up, on the inside, I was feeling this driving desire just to someone to say, I love you. Just those words were just so powerful for me. I felt so ugly. I guess that's one of the biggest things. I felt so unloved, and I just wanted to fit in.
As a vulnerable little girl, unbeknownst to those around her, she was being molested repeatedly.
Here was a guy that I had looked up to, that I had really thought cared for me, and this is the way he showed me that he cared. That's how I learned to love men, or to get love through sex. In high school, I really searched everywhere. Any guy that I thought was supposed to be my boyfriend at the time, I thought that that was the way to show them that I cared for them, was to lay down with them, or was to give myself to them. And I would find myself in a situation where he left me, and I always like, well, what's wrong with me? I gave myself to you. I gave all of what I know how to give, and I'm still felt rejected.
As a senior in high school, Rhonda focused on getting to college.
I was just hoping just for the diploma, really, and to really make my dad proud. I would feel love if I succeeded. In high school, I was dating a lot of different guys at the time, and I found out that I was pregnant. And it was like the worst thing that had ever happened to me. I just foresaw everything that I had wanted so bad in the trash. The day after graduation, I went and had the abortion. And after having the abortion, I didn't think about it anymore. I went to college, and I still sought out the empty hole in my heart. I mean, everything that I thought made me happy, or that I thought I was enjoying, I would go home and I would just feel like awful.
Disillusioned, Rhonda knew she needed something more.
I kneeled on the end of my bedside, and I just really just cried out to God, like, Lord, there must be more to this life. I've tried everything. There is no other answer. I just need you. I just need you. In Isaiah 61, it speaks of beauty for ashes and healing of the brokenhearted. Those things just spoke loud to me, because those are the things that I was experiencing. And it was like such an explosion inside that Christ fulfilled the scripture for me, that he came for me, and he came to heal my brokenhearted, and to heal, to make me beautiful, beauty for my ashes.
Rhonda's newfound joy in Jesus Christ was soon put to the test.
The memory of my abortion came back to me, and it was like a smashing door. It was like I fell on the ground face first. I was really feeling shameful and guilty and really, really sorrowful. My college degree, I hid it because I hated it so much, because I had sacrificed my child for success.
Rhonda sought out counseling, and God began a healing work in her life.
The healing that Christ has brought in my life has helped me to come to terms with my abortion, with my grief, with my shame. Someday I'll see my child. And like, it's so wonderful to think about him being with Christ and one day being able to see that. I've seen Christ really do a work that I couldn't even imagine. Not only does he fill me with his unfailing love, but he also, his forgiveness, this love from the Lord is mine, is has been shown on me, because the creator of the universe loves me. He came for me, to die for me, to heal my broken heart.